Parables from Nature, Volume 1, by Margaret Gatty, first published between 1855 and 1857. This unabridged recording was produced in 2005 by Alcazar Audio Works of Burlingame, California, which holds the copyright thereto. A Lesson of Faith. If a man die, shall he live again? All the days of my appointed time will I wait till my change come. Job 14:14. Let me hire you as a nurse for my poor children, said the butterfly to a quiet caterpillar who was strolling along a cabbage leaf in her odd, lumbering way. See those little legs, continued the butterfly. I don't know how long it will be before they come to life, and I feel very sick and poorly. And if I should die, who will take care of my baby butterflies when I am gone? Will you, kind, mild green caterpillar? But you must mind what you give them to eat, caterpillar. They cannot, of course, live on your rough food. You must give them early dew and honey from the flowers, and you must let them fly about only a little way at first, for, of course, one can't expect them to use their wings properly all at once. Oh, dear me! It is a sad pity you cannot fly yourself, but I have no time to look for another nurse now, so you will do your best, I hope. Oh, dear, dear, I cannot think what made me come and lay my eggs on a cabbage leaf. What a place for young butterflies to be born upon! Still, you will be kind, will you not, to the poor little ones? Here, take this gold dust from my wings as a reward. Oh, how dizzy I am. Oh, caterpillar, you will remember about the food. And with these words, the butterfly closed her eyes and died. And the green caterpillar, who had not had the opportunity of even saying yes or no to the request, was left standing alone on the side of the butterfly's eggs. A pretty nurse she has chosen indeed, poor lady, exclaimed she. And a pretty business I have in hand. Why, her senses must have left her, or she never would have asked a poor crawling creature like me to bring up her dainty little ones. Much they'll mind me, truly, when they feel the gay wings on their backs and can fly away out of my sight whenever they choose. Ah, how silly some people are, in spite of their painted clothes and the gold dust on their wings. However, the poor butterfly was dead, and there lay the eggs on the cabbage leaf. And the green caterpillar had a kind heart, so she resolved to do her best. But she got no sleep that night, she was so very anxious. She made her back quite ache with walking all night long round her little charges for fear any harm would happen to them. And in the morning, says she to herself, two heads are better than one. I will consult some wise animal upon the matter and get advice. How should a poor crawling creature like me know what to do without asking my betters? But still there was a difficulty. Whom should the caterpillar consult? There was the shaggy dog who sometimes came into the garden, but he was so rough. He would most likely whisk all the eggs off the cabbage leaf with one brush of his tail, if she called him near to talk to her, and then she should never forgive herself. Then there was Tom Cat, to be sure, who would sometimes sit at the foot of the apple tree, basking himself and warming his fur in the sunshine. But he was so selfish and indifferent, there was no hope of his giving himself the trouble to think about butterflies' eggs. I wonder which is the wisest of all the animals I know, sighed the caterpillar in great distress. And then she thought and thought, till at last she thought of the lark. And she fancied that because he went up so high and nobody knew where he went to, he must be very clever and know a great deal. For to go up very high, which she could never do, was the caterpillar's idea of perfect glory. Now in the neighboring cornfield there lived a lark, and the caterpillar sent a message to him to beg him to come and talk to her. And when he came, she told him all her difficulties, and asked him what she was to do to feed and rear the little creature so different from herself.
Perhaps you will be able to inquire and hear something.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.